So you are now watching the Blender details and tricks, and this is list number 46. In this lesson, I'm going to make an introduction for sculpting in Blender. We will make an introduction for the basics, and we will explain the brushes. So basically, to enter the sculpt mode, you should go to the sculpt mode, but before that, you must make sure that you have all the rotation and the scale may be applied, and you don't go to the subdivision. But if you want to add some geometry here, you can go for the multi resolution, and we will subdivide it a few times like this. Then I want to make some inset here, and I think now we are done. So basically we'll go for the sculpt mode and hit the T to see our brushes. Basically these all brushes which have been added, and I have explained in a previous video how we can add all these brushes. But now we will explain the most basic brushes, which starts from here, and let's explain the basic one, which is sculpt draw. So the sculpt draw a line such as this, but if you can see here, we have activated the symmetry. So we will deactivate the symmetry, and as you can see, we have here we are now adding an geometry. If you want to subtract, you can click the subtract, or there is a tool or shortcut which is the control. If you click control, you will subtract in the go. So here we have the radius, and the if will increase the radius, and we are now increasing the radius, and shift if will decrease the strength. So you are now decreasing the strength. Alright, this is the first brush, and you have some brushes just such as the snake hook. So this snake hook giving you an geometry, extra geometry like this. So we have also the smooth. So the smooth will smooth an area such as this, and it smoothing the area, and it you should use it a lot in your workflow. And we have the bench. So assume that you have an edge like this, you can bench this edge such as this, so it making an crease. Of course you have the crease, and you can use the crease a lot in your workflow. And this is the crease. So the crease making an edge which is like this, and you can use this a lot in if you want to sculpt an shirt or something which is have an fabric, and you can use this a lot. And as I have mentioned, I explain only the brushes and the basics, and you after that you can use these tools in your model. And also there is a lot of brushes, but this is one workflow which is adding the multi resolution. So this modifier make all the geometry. Even if you go higher, you can see it's making all the geometry, and it's increasing all the vertices. But what if we want to increase only one part? So it's not suitable, and then you can go to another tool. So you can go for the sculpt tool, and we have here the dynamic topology, and I have used the relative detail. There is constant detail, and there is the relative detail. So the relative detail depends on the screen size. Then I will use the detail size, maybe 5. Let's try the 5, and let's go here, and as you can see, we are now adding an geometry. So it's adding geometry only on the area which you draw. As you can see now, the detail has been pushed. And if you want to decrease or increase, so if you go to 20 maybe, you will see that you have lower geometry. And as you can see, it's decreasing the geometry. So if you sculpt, you should definitely start from lower geometry, and then you can go to much higher detail. And there is some tool which you should use a lot, which is let's search for mask, which is here. So the mask work such as this. You draw a mask like this, and after that you hit after drawing a mask, you can click Control I, and after that choose for example the flatten, and let's make the detail maybe 8, and you flat this area like this. You make this area flat. And it should work. Let's go here. And I will smooth the area. And I think it's working. Let's try another brush, which may be this one. And as you can see, we have now drawn a geometry only in the masked area. If you want to clear the mask, you can go to the clear mask. And that was the basics for sculpting, and you have explained the brush. And there is a lot of options which we can explain in later videos, such as the strokes, such as the textures. And we have also explained the symmetry. And there is some options here which we can use. That's conclude for this video, and let's before finishing this video, I must explain that I have started a course on Udemy, and this course will be the basics of product design in Blender 3D, and it will be based on Blender 2.8, and I will leave the link for this course in the comments. So see you in the next tutorial.